Welcome back. You are watching Aussie Indian, and we are bringing you the highlights of 2019, that is, Best of Aussie Indian 2019. And Aussie Indian always takes pride in showcasing and highlighting the achievements of indigenous sports stars. Bo Champion, the NRL legendary player, is one such sports star, and Ursula Mellham, our staff reporter, caught up with Bo Champion and brought this exclusive interview to our viewers. Let's take a look at some of the highlights.
You're watching your favourite Indian television show. It's Aussie Indian. I'm Ursula, and today I am joined by former rugby player Bo Champion, and today we are filming from the Cathy Freeman Park. Miss Cauldron in the background. It's so lovely to have you here today with me, Bo.
Yeah, my pleasure.
So I wanted to ask you first off, where did your passion grow from for the game, and how are your formative years developed?
Yeah, well, rugby league was a big part of my life. Obviously, my family grew up with rugby league, so as a kid I'd go and watch my dad play and all my family play. I started playing rugby league when I was five, and then I was fortunate enough to come through the South Sydney ranks and eventually onto the NRL.
Great. And how much of an influence did people like Russell Crowe, Anthony Mandine and Andrew Forrest have on your career?
I looked up to those guys. They probably didn't have an effect within basically mentoring or guiding me, but especially Anthony Mandine, who was someone that I really looked up to as a kid, and someone that, you know, I aspired to be like. And obviously the other two you mentioned had big impacts on the clubs that I was involved in. And I have really a lot of respect for them two people.
Great. And you actually made way for Greg Inglis due to a salary cap. What prompted this sacrifice?
Yeah, it was just a strange situation. At the time, we probably weren't as a successful club as South Sydney are now. And the opportunity came for Greg Inglis to come to the South Sydney Rabbitohs. And it was a really big opportunity. And I could see the impact that Greg would not only have on the field, but also within the community. An opportunity come up for me to play in Melbourne. Melbourne are a superpower and probably been one of the most successful clubs in the modern era. So the opportunity to go to Melbourne and also allow Greg to come to South was perfect for me, because I love the Rabbitohs, and I knew it would put the club into a better place. So, and I would ultimately work back around where I ended up back at the Rabbitohs anyway. But and we've seen the impact that Greg's had not only on the club, the game, and also the Indigenous community, and also the Rabbitohs in general.
Yeah. And how was it representing the city in the 2010 City versus Country Origin, and how much did it mean to you to actually represent the 2000 Indigenous All-Stars squad?
That was a really big step for me. The previous couple of years before, I was just starting to establish myself as an NRL player. And then probably in 2010, 2011, when I was able to get them rep honours, it was a very proud moment, because I had to overcome a lot of adversity through injury, especially through the first 5 years of my career. So it was just a lot of reward for hard work, discipline, and just staying focused on my rugby league, and that was a bit of a reward at the end of it. Playing in the NRL All-Stars was always a dream of mine. I'm a very proud Indigenous man, and I do a lot of community work and try to be as positive as I can for the kids as they see us as role models. So to represent my culture, my family, and to play on that night was awesome. And we got the win the first year. Unfortunately, we didn't get it the second year, but you can really see, especially that week, a lot of young Indigenous kids, they can see, you can give them a bit of hope. They can strive to something. Definitely. They can try and make their lives better. Even if it's not in the football field, it might be in the school, or it might be just, them believing in themselves to chase their dreams, because they see other Indigenous players from their community doing the same thing.
Great. And you moved to the Gold Coast a little while back. How was that move, and what triggered it?
Yeah, it was a really strange time in my life, and I unfortunately I wasn't happy in Melbourne personally. I had nothing to do with football. It was just myself personally. We've just been isolated from my family, and just away from that football community. I just didn't love it. And an opportunity came up to go to the Gold Coast Titans. At the time, the Gold Coast Titans were a very successful club. They just finished a game away from a grand final, so. I thought it would be a really good move, but unfortunately, again, injury struck. I only managed to play 8 games up there for the Titans. I signed a 3-year contract, but only stayed there for a year, and ultimately found myself back at the Rabbitohs. So it's strange how some things work, some things are meant to be. But yeah, I made the decision at the time what I thought was best for me at the time. Not so much about football, it was more about my headspace and my life.
Yeah.
And ultimately, it ended up putting me back to the Rabbitohs, which worked out well.
Great. Yeah. And how did you bounce back after sustaining all those injuries back in 2012?
Yeah. Well, the injuries actually started when I first started into the NRL when I was 18. I think, you know, as a young kid, I built up a lot of resilience.
Yeah.
You know, I'd been through a few things that, not a lot of other people probably would have been through. So it taught me to, just to take it day by day.
Yeah.
So sometimes you get setbacks in life, whether it be, death, injuries, lack of form, all these things can happen to you. And I think because they happened to me at such a young age, when they did happen to me during my NRL career, I just went back to doing what I did and, all right, we've got a 3-month injury.
Yeah.
What do we do today? Let's get better today, tomorrow, and then ultimately the 3-month time, it'll take care of itself. So that's probably one of the proudest things I take out of my rugby league career was every time I did get injured, I was able to fight back and get myself back into the NRL team.
Great. And you mentioned the Rabbitohs before. Returning to the Rabbitohs back in 2013, did it feel like you were returning back home?
It did, but it was a different place.
Yeah.
You know, as I said, when I come in as an 18-year-old, the club was nothing like it was now. We had a low membership base. We didn't have huge finances.
Yep.
We just did the best we could, and we had a lot of local juniors thrown in before their time.
Yep.
And then ultimately what happened when I went back to the Rabbitohs a second time around was, obviously Russell and Peter had bought the club.
Yeah.
Michael Maguire had come in as the head coach, and they'd just come off a season where they'd finished in the top four. And then obviously we finished top four again and then eventually won a premiership in 2014.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I got injured at the start of the year, but it was really, I was really proud to be a part of that group. As I said, I've seen how the community developed, changed, and it was great for all them long-time South supporters who had stuck with the club for such a long period of time, that ultimately felt that success. And it was something I was really proud to be a part of.
And how was your experience with the Parramatta Eels?
Yeah. Oh, I had a great time at Parramatta. I got thrown a lifeline by Brad Arthur. I'd snapped my wrist actually in 2014. That's what kept me out of the premiership year. And the surgeon actually said he wanted me to retire. He thought it'd be time for me to retire. So I took that on board and thought, well, I'll just retire. I've had too many injuries now. I've had multiple reconstructions to my ankles and shoulders. So I just said, I'll probably retire. Then halfway through that year, I seen another specialist who thought he'd give a lot more movement back into my wrist.
Yeah.
And then I started to think about playing again.
Great.
And then once I could comfortably hold the ball and I had the confidence to be able to pass and stuff like that, I gave Brad Arthur a text because I had a contact out of the Parramatta Eels.
Yeah.
And I just said, look, I'm happy to sign for the minimum wage. I just want an opportunity.
Yeah.
And Brad said, yep, no problem at all. So I went out there. They were a great bunch of guys. It was a great club.
Yeah.
We had a lot of fun, had a lot of laughs. But again, unfortunately, in round two, I tore my ACL. Mm. And I think that was when I went back into the dressing shed after that, I knew that was the end. I sort of said, I'll give it one last crack.
Yeah.
And I'll try and avoid getting injured or try and do my best. But
yeah.
It is what it is, and I don't have any regrets because, if I would have probably retired after the wrist, I might have said, I was only 28 years old, I might have said, well, do I keep going or do I, should I have kept going or should I have stopped? And I think the answer was I should have stopped.
Yeah. Hope you enjoyed that interview with Boat Champion, the Indigenous sports star. We are bringing you the best of Aussie Indian 2019, and we are going to bring you more of it after the break. Stick around.